What's up, guys? Trice here. Just playing meme decks. Disco Lock. So the expansion came out, the Malkazar thing, the Medivh Party expansion came out, and everyone was like, "Hey, Disco Lock's gonna be a thing." So I was like, "All right. I'm down to play a meme deck, right? I'm always down to play a meme deck." So I'm going in. Let me turn the volume up. Not gonna see. Alright. So I'm going in. And it's kinda loud. And I just start messing around with it. So you can see I'm rank 18. The season just started. I've pretty much only been playing Disco Lock. And when you steamroll people by turn 6, and just all of their HP is gone, and they're sitting there questioning, "Wait, what just happened?" You know it's a fun time. This deck is absolutely retarded. Like, I don't know. And I know why it's so good, right? Because you get insane value out of all your cards when they work together. You Soulfire and you discard Fist of Jiraxxus or Silverware Golem, and it's like, okay. Two Malkazars in play, and you discard one card, and that means draw two. Like, the potential for this deck is incredibly high. So the idea is to eke out as much value as you can. Right now this is kind of a bad hand, so I'm basically playing a normal Zoo right now. It's like a little bit worse version of Zoo when it's a bad hand like this. But when you get those insane hands, it starts to get really fun.
Get in there and fight, maggot!
Discard coin? Oh no. That's right, draw card.
Get it out! Get it out!
Yeah, I discarded Power Overwhelming, but it's a meme deck. Right? You've gotta take risks. And when you win the 50-50, your opponent's just like, "Wait, what did I just lose to?" And when you lose the 50-50, you're just kind of like, "Eh, whatever."
Someday I'll be just like you.
Arcane Explosion? No Arcane Explosion. Alright. Mirror Image. Stop it, Mage. He's playing Tempo Mage. Alright, so here's one of those weird instances in this deck where I want to draw something to discard so I can draw another card. Because I haven't drawn any of the cards that are okay to discard. Doom card? Okay.
Sever my wrath!
I don't want to discard Doomguard, but I don't want to play Soulfire this turn. Because if you look at it, Soulfire is deal 4 damage, draw a card. But Doomguard next turn is going to be a deal 5 damage, potentially draw 2 cards. It's like, no. He's using so much burn on my minions. It's like overkilling all. So, 2 damage, 4 damage, 9 damage. That's not. 9 plus 4 is 13, so that's. 13 does not equal 15. So I don't have lethal if I go for the big guessing game of Soulfire, try to discard Fist of Draxxus, and then try to win that 50-50. So I'm just gonna hedge my bets. He has to be able to either kill Doomguard or have Frostbolt to be able to win this turn or this game. He can kill it. Alright. Now I have a Power Overwhelming left. Or just a Fist of Draxxus. Alright. I love beam decks so much. This expansion's great. See, normally I would be playing like mid-range Hunter to try and grind out ranks. But I think I found my new favorite deck. Not only is it good, like really good when it works,
your soul shall be mine.
But if it doesn't work, it's still like kind of okay. So I'll show my deck list after this game. But I'm running like 10 one drops. 13, I think, actually. So turn one plays, I've got two Flame Ents, two Voidwalkers, two Abusives, and then two Malkazar Zimps. So that's eight cards that I can play on turn one. So I'm not afraid to mulligan a two drop. Because the worst thing that happens, I tap. This guy's probably playing Aggro Shaman though, so I want to get on board somehow. This is not helping me. So turn two, Aggro Shaman has Totem Golem. I just need to be able to get on board somehow. So if he plays Totem Golem, I play Possessed Villager. And then he has to play another two drop.
The light protects me.
Okay, Argent Squire. I'm fine with that.
Get it out! Get it out!
Yeah, no, I tap second. But that was gonna be the play regardless. Even if I drew Voidwalker, that was the play. Just because Voidwalker has a potential to die to another Rockbiter. Whereas this has to die to the minion and Rockbiter. So that was always the play. This is an interesting turn. So I don't have anything that I'm okay with discarding. But I have three one drops. So I'm just gonna play one mana, I think. Or I could use a Power Overwhelming and tap. I'm gonna do that. Power Overwhelming and tap. I like that.
Why do you hold?
Alright. I think that worked out a little bit better than what happened. So yeah, again, this hand isn't extremely great. I think I've had a game where I was facing a warrior who just died at turn 6 because he could not deal with like the crazy amount of value that you could potentially get from this deck. So I have Defender, but I want to be able to put Defender on two minions, so I'm just going to keep tapping. I don't have enough mana to do it right now. This will just kind of show what I am. Am I afraid of him knowing that I'm discard? I don't think so, right? He could also think that I'm demon, I guess. Played a lot of demons. Played only one drops. Drake, so he's mid-range actually. That would explain why he's trading a lot. Alright, so now we can play...
You are not boss of me.
Yep.
You are not the boss of me.
My shield. What are you?
That sets up for abusive, power overwhelming, soulfire. Soulfire, draw two cards. I could even intentionally discard an abusive sergeant. Once you start getting more mana, you can decide what you discard. It's no longer RNG. That's what makes this deck playable. That's it. That was the only one that was a question, but still, like, that sucks. Alright. I can still decide what I discard. So.
Yeah, stop yelling!
I can just not discard anything, right?
Get in there! Fight, maggot!
Dog gun!
Probably gonna lose this game. I'm against a mid-range shaman at 8 mana.
Did you
15
bring
life
some
left.
Fish?
15 life left. Yeah, I probably lost this game. Anything that's good to discard is my main issue right now. So, spawn a 1-1. That's gonna happen. That's gonna happen. Do I go Doomguard and hope that I discard Abusive Sergeant and Gang Boss, maybe? Because what happens if I discard Darkshire?
I
don't get to draw a card later. That's fine. If I discard Soul, it's kind of bad. If I discard Imp Gang Boss, it's kind of really bad.
Who dares?
So I discard these two.
Get in there! Fight, maggot!
I have to win soon. Or else he's just gonna outvalue me with his deck. I need to draw something that's okay to discard. Curator, nice. He's a Curator Shaman. He drew 3 cards. Murloc, a Beast, wow! Tyrion, nice.
Okay, so,
smack. Flame Juggler, not bad. I think I just accept my fate. Dang it. Alright, well, you can't win them all. At least I lost against a meme deck, right? Like, a meme deck won. That's all I really care about. Alright, but for anyone who wanted to see this deck list, my Disco Lock deck list. So we've got the double Abusive, double Flame Imp, double Malcazar. Just a bunch of twos. 15 twos. I just created it in a hurry, but it seems to be working, so. Let's see, a double Doomguard, double Fist, double Defender, Silver Golem, Gang Boss, Tiny Knight of Evil, because why not? Goes with the theme. Darkshire, Dark Peddler, because it's this really good two drop. Voidwalker, Soulfire, Power Overwhelming, Possess Villager. Malcazar's Imp, Flame Imp, and Abusive Sergeant. So, in order to try and get good value out of the discarding, you need to have low-cost minions, or low-cost things in general, so that you can kind of decide what you discard to an extent. But then you also want things that are good to discard, so like Fist of Jiraxxus and Silverware Golem. Those are the main two that are actually really good. And then sometimes you just discard Power Overwhelming and you're not sad. Sometimes you discard Abusive Sergeant or Flame Imp or Possessed Villager. Rarely you discard Doomguard and you're really sad. But the idea of this is early on you're going to want to play like Possessed Villager or Voidwalker or Flame Imp and get control of the board that way, normal Zeus style. Follow it up with Abusive Sergeant to trade up. This is when you start getting your Dark or Tiny Knight of Evil on the board, or your Malkazar Zimp on board. And then once one of those are on board, you just start discarding things. You hope that you have Civil War Golem in your hand, and that you discard it. And then it's, you played one mana to deal 4 damage and summon a 3/3. It's pretty good. Or maybe you played a 5 mana 5/7 charge, Battlecry, deal 4 damage to a random enemy and spawn a 3/3. Like, not bad. The defenders are just a trade up. Another option, because there's 12 demons. You can do like Demon Fire for spot removal, or just, you know, having a 5/4 for 3 mana. It's better than what rogues do. And also another option, you can put Succubus in. I choose not to. Just because most of the time on turn 2, you're not trying to discard yet. Usually trying to set up before the discard. Tiny Knight of Evil, because when it works really good. Things that are okay to discard. Doomguard. Yeah. Tiny Minions, Power Overwhelming. Soulfire. Pretty much it. It's pretty much the deck. So if anyone wants to try this out, make your own little tweaks or whatever, just, you know, give it a shot. Let me know how it works for you, what changes you made and everything. The first thing I would look at changing is maybe Defender of Argus, because a lot of times it's just something that you're happy discarding. But other than that, and the Tiny Knight of Evil if you don't like it. But other than that, like Dark Shadow Librarians, a draw 2, 3 mana 2, or 3 mana, 2 mana 2, 3 2, I can't read, 2 mana 3 2, draw, Battlecry, draw a card, Death Rattle, draw a card. There's too many things to say. Anyways, I think that's going to be it for me today. So I'm probably gonna try some other meme decks, maybe some Druid, some Resurrect Priest, good old Patron Warrior, Token Druid, yeah, see what comes up. Maybe Steel Rogue, Thief Rogue. But yeah, we'll see what happens next time. But yeah, that's it for tonight. See ya.